Welcome back to another Joyride video. We're picking the camera up, giving, I guess, everyone an update with the Raptor, because ever since we've gotten the Raptor, I haven't really put out much content with it. I've filmed a few videos with the truck, but never posted it. She actually made the first video with the Raptor.
What are you getting into today?
Just doing yard work. And
yard work?
What are you getting into today?
You.
I think we're gonna talk a little bit about why I regret getting the Raptor or buying the truck. You warned me and you told me not to get it.
She did. She was like, don't buy it, keep your truck.
And I didn't listen at all. One of the main reasons why I regret kind of getting a Raptor towing on it, because these things have a super soft suspension. With it being a gas also, it's gonna struggle a little bit. It'll do it, but do you wanna do that? So I've hauled the trailer once now when we went over to Lowe's to go pick up a bunch of lumber. Truck did great. It actually did really good. There was no car in it. I don't wanna go back to the diesel. Diesel prices have dropped. What?
Nothing, I was just thinking about something.
What were you thinking about?
Nothing.
Just say it. What?
I was just thinking that, what if you traded women like you trade your cars and vehicles and stuff? I mean, it's true.
What? It's true, you said I trade women?
No, I said no. Like, what if you did.
What if,
like, you always are constantly like buying vehicles,
swapping them,
love it, and then you don't like it anymore, and then you get a different one,
and then you regret it.
I'd probably regret it if I did that. That's a question. If your wife or girlfriend ever brings up, don't even answer it.
I get tired of stuff so quick.
I do, but I get bored with it. That's I'm not helping myself here. We're gonna completely like change this topic right now. In the previous video, I mentioned how I got a phone call from the sheriff. Me and my buddy Justin, we were going skating, get a phone call saying that your wife had fallen, gotten hurt, no one was here with her with the kids, and I had to either find someone to, I guess, get the kids, or I had to come home. So, which I was like 30 minutes out, so I immediately like turned around, came straight home. Called the neighbor on the way. Neighbor came over and sat with the kids while she was taken away in an ambulance because she fell, hurt herself pretty good. There's like this little wrought iron basket crate thing that had like a little spike on it. She fell on it. When she fell on it, her arm just like landed on it. I got some video of the actual, but it's probably too.
I can't put that on.
And it was bleeding a lot.
Yeah, that's why I called. Well, I felt dumb calling the ambulance, but I thought I just scratched it.
Yeah.
And then I looked and it was like flopped down and I thought I saw a bone, but it turned out to be like blood vessels later. But I like looked and I was like, oh crap. And I closed it and then I ran over to the kids because I was bleeding like crazy. Like so much blood was pouring. It was all over my arm and I was just trying to hold pressure. And then I was like, what if I hit an artery? And I'm gonna like pass out, no one's gonna watch the kids. And I was like trying to fiddle with my phone but also hold pressure, so I was like, I didn't know what to do. I couldn't search in my contacts or the neighbor, and JD was far away, and Annie drives really slow. She was like 15 minutes away, but it would have taken her an hour to get here. So but, I was like, I'll just call 911 because I'm gonna pass out and the kids are gonna be alone.
Yeah.
But then I felt dumb later because I trucked some of the blood.
You got blood on my truck. I'm trying to sell this thing. Actually, that probably increased the value. What do you think?
Yeah, I have blood on it.
If anybody's interested in the Raptor, it is for sale. I think you did the right thing by calling them because, I mean, you never know.
Yeah, and plus you can never answer the phone because that crossed my mind too. I was like, I'll call JD, he won't answer. I'll call Annie.
Oh man, anyways. What are you doing today?
And then I was like, should I search my contacts? But then I was like bleeding so much and then.
The Raptor is for sale. If anybody is interested in it, it is for sale. $29,000, that's what I'm asking for it. Or best offer, what do you think? $29,000 or best offer?
All right, you ready, hon? Where are we taking you?
We're going to the garden center.
Gosh, I thought low fuel. Let's roll. There's never a dull moment around here. Oh, we have to show them too what we built, right?
Yeah.
Because we mentioned that in the other video. So Laura, this was her Mother's Day present. We went to Lowe's and all the lumber we got, built her something pretty cool. We gotta take her to the garden center to go get some stuff for her garden.
Yeah, and we didn't talk about all the stuff with poor Lena either.
Oh yeah, Lena, oh my gosh. She was really sick.
Yeah. She had an ear infection and we learned she's allergic to penicillins.
Yeah. Oh yeah,
so they gave her antibiotic and she had a very bad allergic reaction. So we were back and forth at the doctor's, urgent care and all that stuff. It's been very eventful lately, hasn't it?
Yeah.
Very eventful.
We're gonna have a lot of medical bills.
Oh, yeah.
And that's why I make YouTube videos and I still have to go to work at a regular job because I've gotta have health insurance because they're a health risk.
What?
Stop trying to put my age in the video.
Balding.
My shirt probably shows my age.
See, originally the plan was to put a nice head unit in this thing. Remember when I was gonna do that? Never got around to doing that. Really, that's all this truck needs. Do that, it'll modernize the interior so much. But I did put these bullet point mounts in there for the GoPro and phone, which is kind of cool because that's bolted in.
Back up right here
so
we can drop
so
the compost in the back.
What? They better not be no compost in the back of this truck.
Hi.
What, you're leaving us out here?
Are we all okay. Getting
what? I thought we were all going.
You'll be alright.
Are we all getting out?
No. Well, mommy don't want us to come.
How am I gonna come?
Meet me in there, okay, babe?
No.
Just meet me inside.
Whatever. I'll wait out here for you. Oh, there she goes. Getting her flowers and stuff. What? What?
I am.
You look excited. Where are you putting all them?
In our yard.
In the vehicle.
Where should I put them?
They're going to be all over.
Tell everybody how you label people in your phone.
So, when I label people in my phone, I put their car next to their name.
Kevin Demon DT500 C8H1TRX Bandit Kit.
So the truck has roughly around 142,009 something. Anyway, we'll just go with 143,000. It's like 142,900. Known issues. I need to remount the mirror. And I actually went to Advance, got the little mounting kit, and put it on. The next day it fell off.
We're hot out now, so maybe it'll
Yeah, work. Well, we did it when it was like cold. One other known issue that it has a manifold leak, exhaust leak. Cold start, you hear it a lot more, and then it just kind of goes away. Right now, you don't even hear it, and it happens every time. You start her up, you'll hear it. It's been like that since I've got the truck. I feel like now, just because of driving the truck a lot, I've gotten not really used to it, but I feel like it's gotten a little more noticeable, or maybe I'm just listening for it more. I don't know. I think it's gotten more noticeable to you.
I didn't notice until you told me about it.
The Raptor, it's around 100. We'll just go with 143,000. It's like 142,900. Back at the house, and I'm gonna give you guys an update, show you guys what I built her for Mother's Day. Well, it's not even nearly done. Well, it's getting close. Just wanted to make this video, kind of give you guys an update with the Raptor. I guess I had a change of heart with it, and I'm regretting selling my F-350. That's kind of just sums up this video. You want to tell them what I built you?
A chicken coop.
So we have this smaller coop over here that we built, or this is basically a tractor supply kit, and that one, what is it, like $1,200 bucks? Something
no,
like that.
No, it was
that.
Like $9.99, I think.
I think they've gone up, and everything's gone up in price. So this coop, it's just really small, and in letting the chickens out here in free range, it's ruining Laura's life, letting these chickens run around the yard.
Between only them, during certain months.
They poop all over.
Well, yeah, they poop all over. That's gotten a little better, though.
Yeah, they were pooping all over our patio or porch.
But the biggest thing is, when all my baby plants are put out, they dig them all up.
Oh, yeah.
So they've killed, like, probably 50% of what I planted so far this year.
Well.
But I can't leave them in that little bitty coop.
We built a little bit bigger one, and then...
But I grew everything from seed, so when I plant it, it's like these little bitty, sometimes they're like that, plants, and they're digging for worms, and I'll come out and everything's dug up, so then I plant it again, and then I dig it up again, then I plant it again.
All right, we're going to show you guys this coop that we built. Before we show you guys this, for the record, I am not a carpenter whatsoever, so keep your comments to yourself. I don't know anything about construction, nothing. They're not gonna keep their comments to themselves, are they?
You're just fishing for compliments.
So we'll show you guys the run part first. This is the run part. It's 12 foot by 24 foot. And you want to show them everything? Or you want me to just do it?
Yeah, I want you to do it.
And then we put the hardwire cloth along the outside. That's what it's called, right? Mm-hmm. And we got our little chicken door, solar powered. One half is coop and the other half is Laura's she chicken shed. What, is that not something?
Yeah, that's, I guess.
So it's like, you'll see once we go inside there, but none of this is done. This is the run part. The kids have been playing in here.
Yeah, it's nice and shaded.
It is.
I want one for us.
You want one for us?
Yeah.
Without the mesh on it though. Well, no, we could do a screened in one to keep all the flies and gnats. Yeah, so we got some windows. Where did you get those windows?
Mom had them for a long time and then she gave them to me to make. I mean, I wanted to build a greenhouse out of old windows, but I only had like 8.
Yeah.
So we used them for that.
Yeah, and it worked out fine. They're like just some old windows. Have not built the door yet. So this is the side for the chickens over here. We just got a little latch right there. The little hen boxes right there. And Laura wanted the mesh over here. So like if she's in here, she could see the chickens. So this side is the chicken side. And we still got to put their little perches and there's still a lot left to do in here. But we've got a majority of it done. And we've got our windows. That's the nesting box door. Did you see the door on the nesting box, Laura?
Oh, no, I didn't. I was looking at the floor. There's not like a lot you have to cut around if you put vinyl down.
I only did the latch on the one side because Logan said to do that.
Oh, yeah. Well, it holds up fine.
Yeah, see? And then I made these. They slide in and out. So basically just put kind of channels in there. And then, you know, because like here, if you back up.
It must be because the other one's more flimsy while it needed two.
Yeah, this one's.
You know how like this side. Would,
because the other one was
this
like.
This one would hang open.
See that piece, that board right there?
Mm-hmm.
Pull it out and put it in that slot.
What slot?
Right there. I made a slot.
This?
Yeah. So now if you open it. Look at me, engineering right there.
Yeah, that's funny. It works.
It does, it works. So, but yeah, we got this little shelf, so that's our little chicken coop, guys.
Did you say you got lights for in here?
Yeah, I got some solar powered lights to go in here. I haven't put them in yet. They're still inside in the box. The door right there is solar powered, which is kind of cool. Solar panel over there. When it gets dark, it's supposed to. You almost have to cover up the entire thing. It's like a garage door. There's a wasp nest right there up in the corner.
Ah!
Did you get him?
I got him. Poor wasp.
What are they doing?
They're digging up my pumpkin patch. Said we're gonna have to fly your drone if we wanna get him to go back in the coop.
Why?
Because they all went back in there when you flew your drone.
That's a cool shirt, buddy. Tell mommy what you guys were playing inside the chicken coop.
We were playing jail.
Who is the prisoner?
He fits through that hole.
Does he?
Liam locked him in there, and then he crawled out that hole. He's an escapee right now. Yep. Does that bring back memories 8 years ago? Coming out
oh
of a little.
Oh my gosh.
That's crazy. There is Laura's Mother's Day chicken coop. Let us know what you guys think of it. We still got a lot left to do. We still got to do all the trim work. We're going to make some shutters for the windows, bougie it up a bit. Yes, that's it for this video, right? That's it. Until the next one. See you guys in the next video. Peace.
Bye.